Hello and welcome back to another video of Answer With Me session. So today I'm going to do a topic on matrices by using paper 11, May-June 2020. So whenever you're ready, please flip to page 12, refer to question 19. Okay, let's begin. So for question part A, you're asked to find P minus 3Q. So this is a formula you need to substitute with the matrix given. Here you are given with P, Q and R. So let's zoom closer. The matrix of P is 4, minus 2, minus 1 and 3. 3Q, Q is 0, negative 1, 5 and 4. Okay, so I repeat, the 3 I'm gonna expand, multiply to every number inside the matrix here. So matrix of P, I just carry it down, leaving the negative outside. So 3 times 0 will give you 0. 3 times negative 1 will give you negative 3. 3 times 5 will give you 15. And 3 times 4 will give you 12. So now you are going to solve it one by one according to their position. So start with the top left. 4 minus 0 will give you 4. Next, negative 2 minus negative 3 will give you positive 1. Bottom left, negative 1 minus 15 will give you negative 16. Lastly, 3 minus 12 will give you negative 9. So fill in the answer with the space given here. Okay, so that's all. B part 1, the determinant of R is 11. Find T. So we have the matrix of R given here. R is 4, 1, T and 2. The formula for determinant for any 2 times 2 matrix would be AD minus BC. So what does this alphabet mean? It means the position of a matrix. A will be here, B here, C and lastly D. So let's substitute according to the letters assigned. A is 4, D is 2, B is 1, T is C. Equal to the determinant, determinant is 11. So by solving this equation, you should get negative 3. So therefore, T is negative 3. Okay, last question. B part 2. Find the inverse of R. So we have the matrix here of R. So I'm going to rewrite matrix of R. We have found T. So 4, 1, negative 3 and 2. So whenever you have inverse, the formula will be 1 over their determinant bracket D, A, negative B, negative C. Okay, what happened here is that originally the A and D is here. However, whenever you have an inverse, their position swap. Therefore, you get the D on the top left, A is on the bottom right. So for the negative B and negative C here on the inverse, the B and C just stayed it as it is. Whenever you have inverse, the B and the C, you have to add a negative in front of it. So therefore, you get something like this. So let's fill in the formula. The determinant for R was 11. So I'm just going to put here. D is 2. So I'm going to put it on the top left. B was originally 1. So I'm going to put a negative in front here. So it will be negative 1. C is here, which is a negative 3. So whenever you add a negative in front and with under the negative, both negative will become positive, so it will become a positive 3. And lastly, A is 4, so 4 will be on the bottom right. So that's all for the inverse of R. You can leave your answer like this, or you can expand this fraction to every number in the matrix here. So it is also the same as how you express it this way. 2 over 11, negative 1 over 11, 3 over 11, 4 over 11. So either way is correct. It's up to you, but you must choose one to express displayed on the space given here. Okay. So that's all from me today. If you have any problem, please drop your comments on the comment section below. I shall see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.